Now that we have discussed the most important design considerations for a crystalline silicon solar cell, we will look at how industry and research institutes have implemented these features to produce record efficiency solar cells. In this video, we will show the ideal solar cell design based on the features mentioned in previous videos, such as surface texturing, passivation, and localized doping. Next, we will move our focus to advanced concepts for solar cells based on crystalline silicon that deviate from the standard solar cell design. Note that many different design concepts for crystalline silicon-based solar cells have been published in literature, and in this video we cannot discuss them all, but we have selected some interesting concepts for you. These technologies are the series of passivated emitter solar cells, the TOPCon technology, and the metal wrap-through solar cell. In the next video, we will discuss some other important solar cell designs. But first, we will look at the overview of the achieved conversion efficiency over the years for crystalline silicon-based solar cell technology. The National Renewable Energy Laboratory, abbreviated to NREL, in the United States, keeps track of the record efficient conversion efficiencies for all solar cell technologies. In this graph from early 2017, we see that the record efficiency for a crystalline silicon solar cell under one sun illumination is 26.6%. This particular cell will be discussed in the next video, but how far are we off from the maximal theoretical conversion efficiency? The conversion efficiency of silicon-based solar cells according to the Shockley-Queisser limit is just above 30% for terrestrial applications. A recent study of Richter et al. In 2013 further elaborates on this limit and concludes that the theoretical limit is somewhat lower at 29.4%. This lower efficiency limit is obtained by taking into account Auger recombination rather than radiative recombination only, as is done for the Shockley-Queisser limit. In particular, in an indirect bandgap material as crystalline silicon, the Auger recombination mechanism is important and should be taken into account. To achieve this limit, the silicon wafer should be intrinsic and should have an optimal thickness of 110 micrometers. Now we know the theoretical maximum conversion efficiency, we will look at three different ways how the industry has implemented the design considerations that we have discussed in previous videos to obtain really high efficiency solar cells. First, we discussed the so-called Pearl solar cell. At the end of the last century, the Pearl solar cell was introduced as a high efficiency concept solar cell. PEARL is the acronym for Passivated Emitter Rear Locally Diffused. As we can tell from this illustration, this design includes all the considerations that have been discussed in the previous videos. The front surface is textured with inverted pyramids and coated with a double layer anti-reflective coating to reduce the reflection. Using two layers for the anti-reflection coating allows to make the transition in the refractive index even smoother, reducing the reflection even more. Secondly, the surface of the p-type wafer is passivated with an oxide layer to reduce surface recombination. The highest purity grade float-zone wafer has been used to reduce bulk recombination. A very fine front metallization grid is deposited using photolithography to reduce the coverage of the front surface and thereby shading losses and to increase the fill factor. And finally, the metal semiconductor interfaces feature locally increased doping to create a selective emitter at the front contact and a local back surface field, or BSF, at the back contact. Combining all these features, the researchers managed to obtain a staggering conversion efficiency up to 25%, which remained unchallenged for more than a decade. The PEARL concept, however, includes some complex processing steps like photolithography that are therefore hard to scale up and are very expensive. A variation of the PEARL concept has been implemented on multicrystalline silicon wafers, leading to the so-called passivated emitter rear contact or PERC solar cell. For this concept, also texturing is applied to the front of the solar cell and the emitter is passivated by the material that is also used as anti-reflecting coating or ARC. But the highly doped regions underneath the front contact for creating a selective emitter have been omitted. The most important feature is a dielectric layer at the back of the cell to increase back reflection and the implementation of a local BSF. Multicrystalline PERC solar cells are currently the most produced crystalline silicon solar cells, and the record efficiency of the 21.3% is held at this moment by Trina Solar. The PERL and PERC design both predominantly focus on front surface optimization and by optimizing collection with a back surface field. For the next design, we will show how the back surface field can be replaced using a clever trick. This is a cross-section of the tunnel oxide passivated contact solar cell, abbreviated to TOPCon. We can see that front surface processing is more or less similar to the PERC and PERL solar cells, but where we previously introduced localized contacts with a back surface field to reduce recombination at the back contact, in the TOPCon solar cell we see a different solution. In order to prevent the minority carriers to recombine at the back contact, a very thin oxide layer of approximately 2 nanometers is placed in between the n-type base and the phosphorus doped n-plus layer. We have to note here that n-type wafers have favorable electrical properties over p-type wafers and are therefore gaining a higher fraction of the market over the historically favored p-type wafers. In generally, the minority carrier diffusion length in n-type wafers is much larger than in p-type wafers since it has fewer metallic impurities. Secondly, n-type wafers are not sensitive to light-induced degradation. These effects are beyond the scope of this course. Now, since the oxide layer is present, it is almost impossible for the minority carriers, which are holes in the n-type wafer base, to reach the back contact of the cell as they cannot pass the potential barrier introduced by the oxide layer. On the other hand, since this layer is kept very thin, electrons are able to tunnel through the barrier and be collected at the back contact with virtually zero loss. Contact patterning, which is a relatively difficult and therefore expensive processing step, is not necessary and the back side of the wafer can be entirely metallized. An efficiency of up to 25.1% has been reported by Fraunhofer in 2015 with this concept, and it is still developed further. Both passivated emitter cells and the TOPCon cells have improved the conversion efficiency of the cell itself by implementing optimal design features. The last technology that we will discuss in this video focuses on module optimization. For a solar module based on standard crystalline silicon solar cells, the individual wafer that form the cells are connected in series by connecting the front metallization grid of one cell with the back contact of the next cell. This process is called contact tabbing. It is a time-consuming and precise processing step that in the past was frequently done by hand. A consequence of these interconnections is that the cells cannot be placed directly side by side, but that a spacing is needed between the cells. This area is accounted as a loss when looking at the aperture area of a solar module. The metal wrap-through technology, in literature often abbreviated to MWT, prevents this loss in module area as it wraps the metal front contact through the base of each cell using a so-called via, and places both front and back contacts side by side on the back side of the solar cells. Evidently, care must be taken that the via does not create a short circuit. Individual cells can therefore be placed much closer to each other. This image shows the SunWeb technology that was demonstrated some years ago by Schott Solar and Solon Solar. This technology can be recognized by its very special front contact design. The metal fingers are surrounding the wrapped through contacts in a very distinctive, almost flower-like pattern. To conclude this video, we have seen that derived from the pearl design, the PERC is the most commonly produced multicrystalline silicon solar cell. The TOPCon design can replace the back surface field and localize contacts with an ultra-thin tunneling layer and full metallization at the back. And finally, the metal wrap-through technology can be implemented for module optimization, allowing the individual cells to be placed much closer to each other.